yeah, most people, for example, do not communicate enough at all. They do not express themselves enough whatsoever. They basically, they don't, they only get the first gear. They only get the low gear. They don't even reach the natural, moderate,
balanced, medium gear, let alone, like, a really good gear, okay? So, for example, today someone was saying to me, you don't want to force a situation, like you don't want to, I was saying you might want to express yourself, and they were saying, well, you don't want to like force it. But I'm saying, like most people aren't even getting onto first gear, like let alone forcing. Forcing would be like the third highest, the third gear, for example. So first gear is too little, moderate, medium gear is a decent amount, and then if you're going to like go excessively, then that's forcing, you know? So most people basically have suppressed and hidden feelings and thoughts and beliefs about other people, okay?
Hey, Digger.
So if you want, okay, so here's the second point I want you to remember, okay? So I want you to ask yourself, do you express yourself enough, or do you have like unresolved problems and guesses and imaginations and beliefs about people? Guesswork, imagining. Okay, so the second thing I want you to remember is, what's the second thing I want you to remember? Yes, you have to, communication chakra from your throat chakra alone doesn't work good. What you want is throat chakra and heart chakra. When you combine those two, you can become a brilliant communicator and really good results can happen. You can resolve conflicts, heal arguments, and avoid conflict and arguments and disconnection and breakups of friendships or unions of any kind. What do you think of the dog? This is Digger. This is the beautiful Digger, and here I am in Cawston, Canada, the organic capital. We're lovely, surrounded by lovely, absolutely 100% organic trees, peaches, nectarines, white peaches, plums. So anyway, I'll get back to the video because I don't want to like spend too much of your time unnecessarily. So for me in my life, let me now go on to the third thing, and I'm going to express to you about me in my life and how, in my opinion, while I'm always still learning, I feel, and other people have said it, that I'm generally a very good communicator. I'm bad at other things, but communicator I'm pretty good at, compared to how I was before at least, or compared to how a lot of people and humans on this planet in 2016 are. So I'm not trying to like compliment myself too much or anything. In my life, the more I used to take a long time to express myself, and I had a whole lot of like emotions within me that weren't nice, like, you know, sadness, confusion, anger, like also regret, like frustration, loads of like unhappy and unpleasant emotions. But as I became a practicer, Everyone who you have an issue with of any kind, or complication or confusion, they become like your teacher and you become their teacher. But if no one expresses, you don't get to practice and become better at communicating and develop yourself. So I'd like to suggest to you to use your emotional discomforts as like a kick up the ass to become better. You know, don't force yourself, so do it when it resonates with you. But also be aware, like, why aren't you communicating? Like, you're not forcing communicating, but you're not even getting into first gear. So why aren't you getting into first gear? So why aren't you getting into second gear? And usually that's because we're afraid to appear not nice or to be disapproved of. We're afraid of confrontation or conflict. And we're afraid. But the thing is, when you combine the communication chakra with the heart chakra, that's when you don't have to be as afraid, because it works out. So what I want to say is, remember this, you want to be with the heart chakra to be on everybody's side. You're not their enemy or trying to hurt them or to be against them, but you're actually trying to improve them, help them develop, grow and heal. And so they can have like an absence and let go of their anxiety and issues with you. So it's healing their union or the relationship, whatever their relation to you is. So in my life, this has been amazing. It's been totally good. And before, I used to wait like days, weeks, months, years. Now, I like, if there's an issue with someone, it's like not hours, but it's like usually quick, like, you know, or even if I miss the first chance, like, it's better late than never. I'll do it a little bit later. Ask someone. If I miss a talk to them in person, I'll write to them on Facebook or in a text message or something, or an email, anything. And then you do with the heart, you're caring and careful, and you're on their side, it's peaceful, and you minimize anything bad whatsoever. And you promote everything good. And you can be often become closer, and then you don't have to think about that anymore. Whereas if you have like loads of unresolved problems with people, then you're carrying loads of baggage. So in my life, I don't carry baggage, basically speaking. I'm free in the moment, and I don't have a whole lot of like stuff stored in me, which is, stuff stored in you is stagnation and blockage. It's like opening the tap. You express yourself, and then it's finished, and then you're free again. You're light, and you're not heavy. You're not carrying baggage. And you open your heart, and you're free when you have your heart open and you have compassion. And when you have your mind open and your heart and your communication chakra, then you can listen as well as to express. And you hear from your heart instead of just from your mind. So you're combining your heart and your mind. So this works like extremely effective in my life. Like, as I said, I'm bad at other stuff. And I have other things that I need to work on. But with this, I'm pretty strong. So I want to help you in this video. So I hope in this video you get to not have the baggage anymore, and you ask yourself, like, but what are you afraid of, like, to communicate with somebody? I'll give you an example, by the way, and this is a form of manifestation, because like some people build a wall or like use bricks and cement. Other people like build and create with their words. Like, words have power, they have meaning, and we should be selective with our words and careful. Digger's happy here, eh? He likes the video. He likes the energy of what's happening, eh? He could be running around, but obviously he likes us two making the video, yeah? Thanks, Izumi. So, I'll give you an example. So to ground what I'm trying to share here, the teaching. So it's not just like an artistic painting that you have to figure out how do the strokes make it. I want to give you a realistic example. Like, yesterday, myself and my beautiful partner and my nice new friend, okay, we got a durian. We got a discount on it, 30%, because part of it was kind of like a bit open, like it wasn't very fresh, a bit soft, too soft, had a crack open. So anyway, we opened it, and I didn't have any because those two said it was like bad, and my new good nice friend said he like felt sick after having it. It was disgusting, the worst thing he's eaten in ages, and unfortunately he swallowed some. So we brought it back. It only cost like, you know, $6.50 after the discount, or like less than 5 euros, but none of it was edible, and it even made him sick. So why should we buy that? Like, why should we be made to pay for that? So we brought it back, we got our money back easily, but I also then said that my friend was sick. Like, usually when like something is broken, you get a refund. But if you're traumatized or made ill or sick or injured from something, then you should get an additional like compensation of some kind. Like, people make lawsuits for this type of thing. But we had no intention of making a lawsuit. I was the main one who wanted it, I suppose. I don't know if they wanted it. I just wanted it extra because he was like disappointed and upset, like a little bit upset or sad or frustrated, like, you know. And I wanted to sweeten the experience for him so he doesn't have to go home sad, like, or like really disappointed, because we were actually looking forward to trying it because we love durian and it's rare. It's like a piece of fruit, if you don't know what it is, from Asia. So we went back to the reception desk. The lovely lady, very friendly. She was like very helpful, good mood. Then she called the fruit and vegetable like produce manager, and she came over, but she said, no, sorry, like, I usually, like, you know, we don't do that sort of thing. You just get your money back, and we don't like give anything extra, or we can't give any. Because I said, like, could you give, he likes organic oranges, like, can you give some organic oranges to him? He'd already bought like 5 packets or something because he likes orange juice, my new friend. But she said, no, sorry, like, usually we don't do that. And I said, well, can you do it this time, like, make an exception? And she's like, no, sorry, like, our store policy doesn't really, like, allow us to do that, or doesn't really, like, we don't usually do it. So I was like saying, okay, well, like, you don't usually do it, but can you do it like this time? Because he got sick. So she sort of repeated herself like around four times, and I kind of like said it a slightly different way. So here I am getting into second gear and like hiring the gears of my communication. But I did it with respect. I wasn't angry. I wasn't giving out to them. I wasn't critical. There was no like negative vibrations. She was just sort of going with the protocol of what's normally done. But this wasn't a normal situation, because it wasn't just like a faulty good or a broken bulb that I needed to like get your money back or replacement. He ended up feeling like he wanted to puke, like vomit and get sick. And he felt unwell. So I tried to explain this to her. So in the end, he was like saying, oh, big corporations, like it's hard to get anything from them, you know, like nothing. So I felt it was very inhumane. Like if it was me and I made someone sick, I definitely want to like make them have a happier experience. So we left them after I'd asked probably around five times. And there's an expression, if at first you don't succeed, try and try again without forcing, like brutally. So if you want to manifest what I want to say, don't give up after the first time. That's ridiculous. That's getting into like half gear. If you want to manifest like a business or a relationship or something really good in your life, you have to usually try between 3 and 10 times at the very least, sometimes like 50, 100 times. So I felt 5 times wasn't enough. So anyway, after we'd already like broke away from the reception desk and we thought, okay, we're going home now, I was waiting on my partner and I saw her, okay, so myself and my new friend are waiting on my partner, and then I saw her and I went back in again, okay, and I thought to myself, like, this isn't good enough, like this isn't fair. So I went back again, okay, and I talked to the big lady who was talking to her human to human. I asked her about her job, like she's a store manager and filling in for someone else, she's like managing 4 sections. I expressed interest and importance into her work and life. It was human to human. There was respect and like care and consideration. So anyway, what happened was the whole massive store manager came, and I just said to him, like, what I'm saying to you, you know, it's not just about getting a replacement anymore. Like, it's nice for him to, I said, I care for my friend. Like, I don't want him to go home sad, like, and sick at the same time. He deserves a little bit extra, just a gesture even, that you care for him and you want to have, don't want him to go home feeling so like losing the deal and like getting sick and everything. So he because he had the power and he was the right person to talk to, he agreed, and we ended up going over and getting like a bag of oranges. If it was me, I would have given like probably 2 bags of oranges at least. Maybe 2 would be enough. It's mostly about the gesture. It's not about like just $3 for a bag of oranges. So anyway, I think that was good. It was a good lesson for everybody. Everyone got to practice something positive. I got to practice like manifestation and not giving up, you know. Where there's a will, there's a way. And how to be a good manifester instead of a victim. Because most people just give up way too early. They're not even in first gear. Then they play the victim card. Oh, life is brute. Life is unkind to me. People are unhelpful and unkind to me. And you just like become a crap manifester. And then you're just acting like the victim, like a baby. So all I was saying is I didn't act like the victim or a baby. I communicated with my heart at the same time. And everyone turned out to be like, it was a lovely, positive experience. And I said, like, nice to meet you and thank you very much. And my friend would be happier now. And he was happy. I stood up for him, which was a nice, positive thing too. Everybody won, you know. And maybe they also learned a lesson too, you know, just to think more about people if they make them sick. So there's my practical story of how to implement communication. If that didn't happen, we went home happy. We went home happy, we did. If that didn't happen, we could have been talking and having baggage for like half an hour or 2 days, like talking about how bad the experience was, but we didn't. So this is what I mean. But this is like a mild example. Could you imagine we're talking about like really serious things about relationships, like alcoholism, cheating, violence, being put down or criticized or controlled by your parents or your brother or your partner. Express yourself. These things are way more important. So if I'll give you an example about forcing, if they had said no, like, we can't help you, sorry, like, and they totally expressed themselves that like they want to get rid of me and they're sick and tired of me, if I had kept forcing and enforcing and enforcing, that would have been forcing. But what I did was just communicate enough and express myself enough with my heart, and it worked. So manifesting means you do it until something works. So it's not about doing it like 10 times, it's doing it until it works. Same with business. You don't just give up when you're getting things started. You have to keep doing it if you like what you're doing, hopefully, presumably what you like what you're doing. So anyway, keep improving, and the more you practice, the better you get, and then the faster you can do it, and you do it with your heart, and you're better, and then everything's fixed and things work out lovely. It was a positive experience. So I'll leave you with that, everybody, and I encourage you to check out my playlist, which I'll put out here, on people, communication and relationships, so you can become a much better communicator and learn to deal with people much better too, and a far more empowered communicator. There's so many videos in that playlist about relationships. It's so helpful to you. If anyone would like one-to-one coaching or to support my work, you can get coaching from me. You can see in the link below. As well as, I appreciate anyone who wants to also share the video, thank you, and comment and like, favorite, or share with your friends and family. I really appreciate that, because it's my passion, extremely dedicated work to help you or anybody and humanity at the same time, to change the world, to be a much nicer place for everybody to live in together. All this stuff that's going on, like, we're changing, but it doesn't have to stay that way forever. So the more the lot of us work together to improve and heal ourselves, and then improve and heal the world, the faster it'll change. That's the only solution. No one else is going to change the world for us except for us together, collectively. So get busy healing and changing yourself for the better, and expanding yourself, and help others do the same, and work with your passion and calling. So if I can help in any way, along with health coaching also, and relationship coaching, check me out below. I'd love to work with you. I'm very enthusiastic and passionate about it, and dedicated. As well as I also have a herb shop with herbs, superfoods, enzymes, and essential oils, which really help the body, mind, spirit system also. Really, 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 really nice. Highly recommend all of those things I said. Lately, I love essential oils immensely, and herbs totally healing my body and helping me so much, because I used to be sick. But anyway, I won't ramble, so have a beautiful day, and much love and respect to you and your family, and I hope you and your family are well. And until then, thanks for all your love and support, and I'll catch you again in another video. And if you're new, subscribe. Other than that, thanks for the shares. Thank you. See you again. Have a nice day. Thanks for the recorder.